worship you and thank you, Lord. Loving Father, I acknowledge your name this morning to give all the glory, God. You are a wonderful, wonderful God. I thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to welcome your presence. I welcome your presence in this prayer, God. I welcome you, Lord Jesus. I welcome the Holy Spirit. I welcome you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. I give all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. How are you? Hi to you. I want to welcome you in the name of Jesus. Welcome. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much for joining us. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Ontario, Canada. Welcome once again. I am going to talk to you the subject called The Mouth of the Wicked. The Mouth of the Wicked. Yes, deliverance from the mouth of the wicked, or you can call the mouth of the wicked. There is powers of the of wicked. There is mouth which is very wicked. Jesus himself was against with the wicked mouth. Jesus himself was really against with that, with them. So I'm going to look for the book of Matthew. The book of Matthew 12, verse 34 to 37. Yes, God, we thank you, Father. The book of Matthew 12, verse 34 to 37. The Bible says, "You snakes, you are so evil. How can you say anything good? What people say with their mouth comes what fills their heart." This is the Son of the Living God. This is Jesus himself calling people snakes. People are snakes. They chant like snakes. They talk. The wicked mouth, it is a mouth like of snakes. You see people chanting. Today they say this, tomorrow they say something else. They use their mouth to curse people. The occult, they spend time, witchcraft, they spend time cursing people because their mouth is full of wicked. Now Jesus was looking at them and he called them snakes. Jesus called them snakes. He called them, "You snakes, you are so evil." Look at that. That's why our prayer is not a prayer, a matter of joking. That's why we use very powerful prayer that would attack the enemy. That would put a stop from the mouth of the wicked. You see, Jesus himself, he called those people snakes. Because they were changing, they were liars. They were evil, they were wicked. They were so wicked. When they were with Jesus, they were pretending that they are together with Jesus. But when they are not there, they are evil. So Jesus looked at them and confronted them. That is why you need to confront your enemies. You have to confront them. Jesus called them name. He called them, "You snakes. You are so evil." Look at that. "You snakes, you are so evil. How can you say anything good? What people say with their mouths comes from what fills their hearts." You know, many people, they are suffering because of what their fathers have done to them. Some people are so wicked. They do wicked and wicked thing. Now they are affecting their children. They are not here. What they did, what they planned for their children is what now children are going through. It is not them. It is not you. It is your father. It is your mother. What your mother has done to others, now it is coming to affect you. That's why we need to pray. Because Jesus knows them. Jesus knows that they are wicked people's mouth of snakes. The snakes start changes like grass. In the grass, there is like a green snake in the grass. So Jesus condemned them. Verse 35, the Bible says, Those who are good have good things saved in their heart. That is why they say good things, but those who are evil have hearts full of evil. And that is why they say things that are evil. I tell you the truth. I tell you that everyone will have to answer for all careless things they have said. This will happen on the day of judgment. Your words will be used to judge you. What you have said will show wherever you are, whether you are right or whether you are guilty. You see, your words that you are using will judge you. That's why you say your sins will find you. You can do sins, you can hide, you can do, but your sins will find you during the judgment. That's Jesus said himself. Many people, many pastors, many prophetess, many prophets will come to me and say, we prophesy in your name, we heal people. But Jesus will tell them, I don't know you. Because of their mouth are so wicked. They are so evil and evil. So we pray that wicked mouth, you will be delivered from wicked mouth. Wicked mouth are the ones that are making you to go through what you are going through right now. Wicked mouth of the witches, they are the ones that are attacking you and making you miserable, living the life you are living right now. But I'm going to revise for you. I'm going to reverse the wicked mouth that has said against you, that has spoken against you. The wicked mouth that have said that they have cast you. Because you see what Jesus said. They will be charged. Let their wicked words that using against you be charged against themselves in Jesus' name. I pray that God would deliver you from this wicked mouth, from satanic mouth. You see, Jesus himself charged them. Jesus told them, this will happen on the day of judgment. Your words will be used to judge you. Your words that you are using will be used to judge you. Because people are so judgmental. Some people, even they call me, already they have the answer. They want to test me. Yeah, they go to Sakek and Sakek has told them things. Now they want to confirm from me. And when I say they want to control it because they are so evil and wicked. Apostles, they call me. Pastors, they call me. You know, some pastors, they go to witch doctor. They go to Sakek. They go to false prophets. Now they get the information from there and then they come and use to test people, to test women and the women of God. I'm telling you that the very words you are using will come to judge you. Your sins will be found with you. Everything you are doing to yourself. You are not doing to anybody. You are doing to yourself and your children. But because wicked, they don't care about their children. They are so evil. They don't mind their children. If they care for their children, they cannot do what they are doing. When a witch decides to wave a family, thinks that he will go free, it will backfire and destroy them. A lady, a family in my country, they were traveling, eight of them. And then evil arrows, satanic witchcraft arrows fired to them. And these people were vanishing in an accident. All of them died. Their whole family vanished. Now it happened, when these people died, now the other people, the members of the family were left. When they heard this, they were rushing, they were shocked, and they were trying to go and see what happened. Then on their way, they also got an accident and few of them died. And when they were crossing the road, another one died. It's almost 15 people died in one at the same time. Look at the wicked that has been fired to that family. Now tell me if these people will go free. The judgment will fall upon those wicked. Wicked people who sitting on the mat, chatting on you, calling your name, speaking evil against you. I pray that let that mat turn against them and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. That's why Jesus was calling them snakes. Snakes is a very dangerous animal. Snakes are the form of Satan. Snakes are is a form of Satan, Lucifer. He changes. When he went to deceive Adam and Eve, he went there And it was very cunning. Satan, the snake is very, very cunning. So he deceived Adam and Eve, and they obeyed him. And now the same snakes, he was operating in the time of Jesus. Jesus rebuked them, saying, I know you who you are. You are snakes. You are snakes. You are not good. You are so evil and wicked. Jesus confronted them. It is better to confront the enemy. It don't wait. When David was confronting the enemy, he cast them. He tell them, let your children become fatherless. Let your wife become widows. That is what David prayed. David said, you wicked, you cannot joke with me. I am going to raise up the altar of prayer to destroy you. I'm going to pray that God will destroy you. The Bible says in Psalms 35, he said, let the angels of God chase them. Yeah. You know, when Jesus was calling them like it, it was very serious because of the wicked. When you look at Psalms 35, Psalms 109, and you see the dangerous prayer David was praying against the wicked. The wicked, they are so wickedly. They can be your friend tonight. Now, they pretend to be good friends, but when you are not there, they are great enemies. They are snakes. They turn against you. They speak evil. They plan to destroy you. I know some people, they are under heavy attack from the wicked mouth, from the wicked people. I pray that God will deliver you. Let's look from the scripture of 1 Samuel 24, verse 32. The book of 1 Samuel 24, verse 32. The Bible says, as the proverb of the ancients says, out of the wicked comes forth wickedness. But the Lord will deliver you. But my hand shall not be against you. Yeah. So if wicked is doing evil against you, the Lord is going to deliver you. My God, I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, I thank you, God. I pray that wicked mouth, they are easy to curse. They like cursing. They are so wicked. They plan everything. They plan is evil. They don't want to see you with anything. I know this man. He is a prophet. I don't know what kind of a prophet, but he's called a prophet. This man, I didn't know that he had a problem of traveling. He doesn't go anywhere because he doesn't have paper. So when you tell him that you are going somewhere, you are traveling, he feels so bad and he put a lot of curses. He feels curses. He was talking to me, but I didn't know he was having that problem. He has been in this country for a long time, but I didn't know that he didn't have papers. Until I went to ask God, why is it this man feels so bad when somebody is going to preach or taking the gospel somewhere else? Then the Lord revealed to me that this man is jealous because he doesn't have paper. And now he feels that if he chants and destroy the meeting of those people. So that is wicked. That's what Jesus said. Many prophets, many prophetess, many pastors, many, many people would come to him and say, Jesus, we preached and we healed people. We prophesied. We say this. Jesus will say, I don't know you. You are wicked. Your mouth is so wicked. You are a witch. You've been witching church. You've been witching people. That's how it is. So out of the wicked comes forth wickedness. The wicked people, the wicked mouth, it comes wickedness. So when they come wickedness, a wicked person does not want to see you with anything. If they see your business, they want to close down. They can go chant and speak evil. If they see anything you are doing, they will not sleep. Some wicked people, they come to me and ask me to offer me money so that I can train them, I can show what I'm doing. Yeah? I have seen wicked, they are so disturbed. They chant, they pray very hard, satanic prayer against our ministry, against me. But I know, I confront them eye to eye. I confronted them in the name of Jesus Christ. You have to confront your enemies. Call them by name. When Jesus called them snakes, he was not joking with them. He knew that these are snakes are around him. So the wicked that is around them, around you, shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Anyone who is wicked in your environment, in your life, shall be destroyed and be disgraced in Jesus' name. Let's look another scripture from Isaiah, the book of Isaiah 32 verse 6. The book of Isaiah 32 verse 6, the Bible says, "For a fool speaks nonsense. A fool speaks nonsense, and his heart inclines towards wickedness. To practice ungodliness and to speak error against the law, against God." You know, that's why you see those people, they are so foolish. You see, they are writing, they cast, they say things against God. Yeah, those are wicked. They are so wicked and wickedly. You don't have to do that. Look at that. This is the Bible, this is the word of God. "For a fool speaks nonsense." You see, that's why I told you those people are saying, writing those words, cursing me, speaking evil. They are wicked. They are so wicked. That's wickedness. Yeah? And their words will catch them. They will not go free unless they repent. Any wicked person around you, any word they are using against you, it will turn back to themselves and destroy themselves. It will not affect you. You are protected. The Bible says, "No weapon formed against you shall prosper." Don't fear them. Although they have already attacked you, although they send arrow, the arrow is in your body. I'm going to pray for you that the arrow will get out in Jesus' name. Every damage the wicked has done to you, I destroy them. I pray the deliverance from the wicked. What the wicked have done you, I pray total deliverance today in Jesus' name. The sickness the wicked has put to you, I pray deliverance in Jesus' name. The enemy that has put you poverty, what the wicked has done to you, to put you in that situation, to destroy your business, to destroy your work, I am going to reverse it. God is going to deliver you in Jesus' name. The problem you are, the situation you are facing in, it is because of the wicked. The wicked, the mouth of the wicked. This is the mouth of the wicked. They speak against you. They speak evil against you. They curse you and chant against you. This is the work of the wicked. It is foolish and nonsense, as the Bible calls them. I pray that God would deliver you this morning in the name of Jesus. The Lord Almighty, I've heard your cry. The Lord Almighty, I've seen your affliction. When the children of Israel were suffered in Egypt, Lord heard their cry, heard their problem, and God delivered them. So today, God has heard your cry. God has seen your affliction. God has seen your suffering from the mouth of the wicked, because you don't know what to do. But I'm coming to you to destroy and reverse and break and cast out every satanic mouth that has been spoken against you. Everything that the enemy has said about you, I am going to reverse them in the name of Jesus. I break them and I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I'm going to pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. I am commanding every evil association against you. I command them to be scattered in the name of Jesus. Every evil association, every evil mouth that is speaking against you, I command them to scatter. I command that mouth to be weathered. I command them, that tongue that is racing against you, I command them to cut into pieces in Jesus' name. Let every wicked spirit working against you fall down by their wickedness in the name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty, by the power in the blood of Jesus, let the fire, let the thunder of God, and destroy every wicked spirit working against you to fall down and be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let them be destroyed with their wicked. Let their wicked turn against them and be vanished in Jesus' name. By the power and the blood of Jesus, I reverse every word, every satanic word, every evil mouth that have opened and cursed you and put a curse on you. Let the power and the blood of Jesus Christ destroy them in Jesus' name. Let all the wicked spirit working against you fall by their own wickedness and fall down and die in Jesus' name. Yes, God. I want to thank you, God. I pray that, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, every wickedness that has been done against your life, stumble and fall down. I command them to stumble and fall down in the name of Jesus. Every wickedness that has been done against you, every satanic mouth that has been turned wickedness against you, let this wicked be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Any wicked, any damage, any affliction, anything that has happened to your life from the mouth of the wicked, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will deliver you in the name of Jesus Christ. Glory be the name of Jesus. You, when we pray this prayer, you agree, you say, amen, amen, let it be so. Because these wicked have done so wickedly. Yeah? How can they see a child, even a child of 1 year or 1 day, they want to kill that child? They have put spells on you. They have put chants on you. They put chants. They program so wickedly against you. They put chants. When they put chants on you, the chants will find you and kill you. You make mistakes by yourself. You make great mistakes. When they do manipulation, witchcraft manipulation, they send witchcraft manipulation, and then you do mistakes by yourself. Nobody's doing for you. It is you alone. Yeah? You do great mistakes. Now, because of that mistake, you end up kill yourself or you end up prison forever. That is how wicked they can do. They program. They program that you will do mistakes by yourself. Now, when you do these mistakes will destroy your life. Like what Samson did. Samson went and got a prostitute and married the witch. And this witch killed him because of chants that was programmed by the wicked. The witchcraft, they program some program in your life. They will say, go to college, have a certificate, get a good degree, but you will never work. You try work, nothing is coming. You try everything. You are 50, 60 years. You've never achieved anything because of witchcraft, wicked mouth of saying. The program so evil. Therefore, I pray that God will destroy the wicked of the mouth in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Some people, they work so hard. They start ministry. They don't stop you starting things. They don't stop you starting business. They don't stop you to do things. You will start business. You put your money there. Big business. They will give you relief of 2 months or 1 month. Then they will come after it and destroy it. Then you lose that business. They don't stop you. They say, okay, go and get your mortgage. Get everything. Now when you are enjoying, at the point you want to say, okay, now I'm going to do this, they will come for you and they bring you down. You will lose everything. Those are the wicked. They will start attacking your finances. You will not have any money to pay. After that, you lose everything. That is the wicked. That's why I'm coming to pray against those wicked. This is why Jesus was calling them snakes. Because the snake can bite you anytime. They change. They pretend to help you. They are your help, but they are not. They are enemy. I pray that God will destroy them in Jesus' name. Any good thing that the enemy has removed from your life, your home and your work, be restored immediately in the name of Jesus. I pray. Any good things that the enemy has removed from you, the enemy has taken away your husband, enemy has taken away your wife, enemy has taken away your children. Yeah, I pray that they will repress immediately in Jesus' name. Enemy has taken your job. You have just been fired or you have resigned. You have no job. When you resign, you don't have a job. That is wicked. How can you resign and now you are looking for a job? That is wickedness. I am praying that God will restore everything that you have lost in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, glory be the name of Jesus. Any good thing the wicked has removed from your life, I pray that God will restore them 100 times, 100 fold, as my sister says, as Treasure says. Yes, you will be restored. Even the time you have been wasted, you have been not been working, all this time will be restored in Jesus' name. I pray that God will restore them. I command every spirit of wickedness that has ever had anything to do with your life, right now, from the womb to gather together, now in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I command every spirit of wickedness that has ever had anything to do with your life, right now, from the womb to gather together, now, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus. You forces of wickedness that you have gathered, now receive the judgment of God in Jesus' name. I command every forces of wickedness that have gathered to receive the judgment of God in Jesus' name. Let the wicked, let the mouth of the wicked receive the judgment of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let the judgment of God fall upon the mouth of the wicked in the mighty name of Jesus. Any wicked anywhere around you, let the judgment of God fall upon them in Jesus' name. I pray that the wicked will not go free because God will judge them. Jesus has said they will be destroyed in the name of Jesus. They are so wicked and evil by the power and the blood of Jesus. I pray that God will deliver you from the mouth of the wicked, from the evil of the wicked, what the wicked are planning against you in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power assigned to program your problem, I command them to die. I kill you by the powers that establish heaven and earth in the name of Jesus. Every power assigned to program prolonging your problem, every power assigned to prolonging your problem, you've been sick for a long time. You have been in that situation for a long time. You have been single for a long time. Now is high time to command that power to die. I kill those powers in the mighty name of Jesus. You have been single for a long time. You are living loneliness. I destroy that power in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, that is the work of the wickedness. It was not the plan of God to live single, to live that life you had. It is the power of the wickedness. God created two, and now you are living alone. You have been loneliness. You feel so lonely. You feel like you have nothing. It has going on years and years. I am coming to that power. I am coming to that wickedness. You wickedness, get out of this person. Years and years. Year goes round like that. You are still the same. Let those powers be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I bind them and I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. You have been crying. It is a serious matter. This is a serious matter. You have been crying every time. Nothing is working for you. You try everything. Nothing is working. Nothing is working for you. Yeah? You have been alone. Even at work, you have no friend. You can't get a friend. Nobody. You are by yourself. You feel so depressed. You feel so sad. You are cried until now. You just look things like that. Those are the works of the wicked. They are programmed that is what is going to happen. Remember, the Bible says what is what's written. Jesus was wiped away. The book of Colossians. And the writing that was written of you, Jesus Christ has taken away from you and has wiped from the handwriting which was written about you. Therefore, I am praying any evil person that is working against you, I command the fire of God to consume them in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every power assigned to program your problem, I command them to die. I kill you by the power that establishes heaven and earth in the mighty name of Jesus. Every instrument of wickedness assigned against you, I command them to be backfire. Every instrument of the wickedness, every instrument, every weapon the wicked is using against you, I command them to backfire, backfire, backfire. I command them to backfire, to go back to the sender, to go back to the sender. Every instrument of wickedness that is using against you, I command them to go back to the sender. Let those weapons, let those instruments they are using against you, the method they are using, whatever they are using, let it go back to destroy themselves in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Lord, I thank you, Father. God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, God, arise and set the altars of the wickedness fire, on fire, in the name of Jesus. I pray that God set the altar of the wickedness fire, set on fire, in the name of Jesus, where they are sitting, where they are chanting, where they are saying, mentioning your name, let them catch fire and burn to ashes. Yes, Lord, I want to thank you, God. I pray that the mouth of the wicked will be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I bind that mouth of the wicked. You will be delivered from the mouth of the wicked. The mouth of the wicked that curses you all the time, that has been programmed evil against you, let that mouth be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every mouth of the wicked speaking against you, I command them to shut up. To shut up in the name of Jesus. Every mouth of the wicked speaking against you, I command them to shut up in the mighty name of Jesus. Let their mouth be shut up by the power in the blood of Jesus. My God and my Father, I pray deliverance from the mouth of the wicked that have damaged you, that has done evil than good in Jesus' name. Every damage that the mouth of the wicked has done against you, I reverse it and destroy them. Every curses that the mouth of the wicked have cast you, I reverse it and break them to pieces in Jesus' name. Lord, I want to thank you, Father. I want to honor you, God, my God and my Father. In the name of Jesus, I break and destroy every satanic mouth that has damaged you. Where you are being damaged by the satanic mouth, I destroy them. Every wicked mouth, what they have damaged you, everything they have damaged you, your business, your marriage, your job, your career, I damage them in the name of Jesus. I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, my Father, I want to thank you. I commit your people into your hand. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus, let them be restored. Let them restore what they have lost. Let them be healed. The damage the wicked has done to their life in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them be healed. Let their body be healed in Jesus' name. I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, the prosperities that is in the mouth of the wicked that has taken from you, I command them to form it in Jesus' name. I pray that let the wicked form it your prosperity. Your prosperity in the belly of the wicked that is only in their stomach. Let that stomach pass. Let that belly pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Anything the wicked has been holding against you, let it die. Let them destroy it in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, I am lifting up your name, God. I want to thank you, Jesus. I lift your name up, my God. I destroy the powers of the wicked. Wicked that has come and destroy your life, taking your wife, taking your husband, taking your children. Let this wicked be destroyed in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I cover your people with the precious blood. By the power and the blood of Jesus, I seal this prayer with the precious blood in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. Have a wonderful time. I have to stop here. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye to you. Remember to call me if you need prayers. You call me. Our number is 647-608-5207. Once again, our number is 647-608-5207. Call me if you need prayers. I will pray with you. I know there's powers of the wicked that is attacking you so hard. Many of you are suffering because of the mouth of the wicked. You have no idea how much the wicked has damaged you. You've been doing your best, you have been doing everything, but you have no idea. Therefore, I am coming to destroy their ways. They will not go free in Jesus' name. Call us. Our number is 905-487-7196. Also, remember to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. We have email. If you can't get us, we have email. You can email me, or you can email to us, overcomersdhm@gmail.com. Overcomersdhm@gmail.com. When I receive your email, I will respond. You see, I've been responding a lot of email. Therefore, if I didn't respond to your email, I will respond immediately. So there's some email I have not responded, but I'm coming to them. Don't worry, I will talk to you. I pray that God will help you. Text me, send me WhatsApp, send me email, text message if you need me to help you, to pray with you. And I will come to you. I will come to you. And I schedule you so that I can pray for you. If you need the deliverance of this wicked mouth, I will help you in Jesus' name. Thank you so much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Tomorrow, we are having our night vigil. We are having midnight prayer. So we'll be doing midnight prayer tomorrow, Monday. So today, we have finished our day, 8 o'clock service. We are going back to midnight. Tomorrow, we'll be starting midnight. Monday to Thursday is midnight. Therefore, I pray that God will help you. Invite your followers, share these videos. It is in Periscope. You use share in your media, your Twitter, your Facebook. Share to your friends so that they can also get this message. People, they are servant, they don't know what to do. But God has given me a big revelation how to deal with those wicked. Thank you very much. God bless you. And have a wonderful time. Thank you. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful time. God bless you. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. You know I love you, and that is it. Call me. I want to become your pastor. I want to become your spiritual mother. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful time. Bye. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yes. Yes, treasure. Yeah.